Hello guys, and welcome back to Epic Mentorship. Today we are going to look at how to design a fillable form using the LibreOffice. So to start with, all you need to do is to just come to your browser to download the LibreOffice. So to get that, you just come to your browser over here, and then you just type LibreOffice. It's a very popular alternative to our Microsoft Office. So once you search for it, the first option that comes, so this is LibreOffice. Come over to the search bar here and just search LibreWriter. Okay, you can see it here, and just click on it. When you launch your LibreOffice, it looks very much similar and familiar to the Microsoft Office that we have. If you have used it before, you will know the similarity is quite visible. So once you launch it, you can start filling out the things that you have. For example, I brought in the UTP Toastmasters Club logo to just put. You can put in any logo of your choice if you want, just to show that I have a logo with me for this. So I put in the logo, I put in this description that it's a registration form. This is just a table that I just put. So you can put the table the normal way. You can just come over here and decide the number of rows and columns that you want. I just put it a 3x6 table. And I try to merge where necessary. You can see the table control down here. You can increase, you can bring in rows above, you can bring in rows below, and all that. Rows, column by the side to the right, and you can remove or delete columns or rows as you wish, and you can even delete the whole table as you wish. So these are just the controls, some of the controls for this particular table. So I've just designed it to my liking, the way I want it to appear in the real sense. So now we can start the real form creation. So to start, we can come over here. At the top, you can see we have the form. When you click, you have the form properties down here. All the things that you need, you have them. So you can see the design mode, the control wizard, the labels, the text box, the checkbox, and all that. This is the first way of accessing all these features. But then if you want to have it in a very, very easy and comfortable way, you can come to view over here. You can go to toolbars. Okay, and then you can come all the way to form controls. Once you click on form controls, you can see them just by the side of your form. There are a bunch of other options over here to choose from. Like we can see, we can always bring cursor back to the select option. You can see the design mode. This is the, this enables you to design the form. And once you're done, you can click out to see the preview of what you have designed. And so much more. Toggle form control wizard. You can see the form design and labels. You know, these are checkboxes. We will use some of them as we move in the description or in the form design. So without wasting much of our time, once we bring in these, you can notice that at the bottom here we have another set of icons that just appeared. So the most important among all of them is this display grid. You can click on it to enable it, and you can enable the snap to grid also. You can just enable it. This gives you the control to be able to draw your forms accordingly, and it gives you an idea of the sizes so that you can work kind of perfectly with other boxes relative to you, the boxes you are designing. After enabling all this, you can just kickstart. So the first thing I have is the question. You have to write your full name and your phone number, and by this you can come over and use the text box, because it requires the text box to fill in this. Okay, so we'll click on the text box, and then we come over here and just put down the name. Once you put in this form, you double click on it to see a bunch of properties from the box. You can see the first is a description. This is text box one. You can leave it as a text box one, or you can rename it if you want. But I used to leave it sometimes. Sometimes you can give it a label. There are other things you can give, maximum length. Okay, for example, when you want to put when you want to limit the number of wordings, right now it's zero, so it has no limit. You can put in as many words as you want. But if you want to limit it to 10, 20 to 30 words, you can just enable it directly from here, right? So there are other bunch of options which you can check. You can see the positions. You can adjust the width and height if you want. Down here, you have the background color. You can choose from the background color and use any color that you want. You can choose the text type. Right now, it's single type because it detects that the answer box is so small, so it put it as a single text line. Later on, when we use a bigger location, you can see it can enable multi-line so that you can have more than one line as an answer. So you can put in password, you can put other things down here. So you are free to check through to understand how it works. So once you're done, you can just close this, and this is your form where your user can fill in the full name. Okay, next we have the phone number, same as this one. We can just draw it. You can just draw it. This is the advantage of the snap to grid. It try to make it correctly rightly positioned. This is text box 2, so no need to put in any limitation. Same. So put in your full name and your phone number. Next is the date of birth. This is the calendar option. This is the date field. Once you click on this, you come over here and just drag and put the date. So you have the option to double click to check through some of the fields that you can fill up. It's just similar to the other one. You can put in the label field if you want. And then down here you have the date and time feature. You can specify what kind of feature that you want the user to fill up. So I usually use the drop down option, which you can see just down here. You can say drop down. I used to enable this to say yes. Okay, so the user can click on the arrow to see the drop down. So right now we are on the design mode. We can click out to see a sample of how the form is going to look like. So when we click out, you can see this is a form. You can fill in your name, put in your phone number, and when you come to the date of birth, you click on this arrow, you can see a number of you can specify a given date. For example, I can choose this date. I can check from the year. We can say 2021, and you can say January 14th, and then you can say click, or you just say today. Okay, once you say today, it's going to give you this date directly. Okay, so now we can go back to our main design mode. So once we are back in the design mode, the next thing is we have the option to fill out the years of experience. You put in years of experience as a Toastmaster. Let's try to put in some option button here so that the user can easily specify his years of experience. For example, we can click this and then we can put in the years of experience. Let's say we release, and then we can double click, and in the option we can put less than one. Okay, so the person can fill less than one. From here we hit enter to go to the next line, and then we can click to have the second option. Okay, so double click 1 to 3 years, click out, and then we put in the another option. But then before then we have to hit enter to go to the next line. We put another option, let's say above 5 years. You can put this. You can always increase the size so that it fits up the content. Okay, you can increase a little, so we have it above 5 years. So what, less than 1 year, 1 to 3 years, and above 5 years. So another thing I need to show you over here is that this is your one click, one option buttons. Once you click on less than 1 year, it's going to disable all the other selections. So to be able to have this correctly done, because maybe later on when we have another option bars, we may have issue with the arrangement. So over here you have to put in one thing, it's very important, the group name. Okay, so we can just put here experience. We create a group name, so we know this is under the experience group, so we know easily this falls under the group category. All right, so let's double click on the second one also, make the group name experience. All right, click out, and then the last one also we make it experience. So once we are done, we know that our option is complete, and we can resize this to make it smaller so that it can accommodate the options that we have. Now the next is the reason for joining. Why do you want to join our club? So you can put a text here, but in this time around it's going to be a bit bigger so that we want you to tell your story and all. So when you double click on it, you can put in the details if you want, and then you can come down here to see that it automatically made it a multi-line type of text, so no need to specify. So you can type anything you want over here. So you can type anything you want over here. We can check on that. When we click out, you can type. So this is multi-line, so it's confirmed. So you can come back to the design mode. We're done with this. So payment schedule, how often do you want to pay? You want to pay yearly, you want to pay monthly, you want to pay every 6 months. So over here we can use the list box. So when you click on the list box, you can just create it down here, and you can say cancel this. You can double click on this, click, and then you come back to the most important thing here is to come to the list entries. Okay, so here you have to put in the list entries. You click on this, and then you can put in all the entries that you want to put. So we can say monthly, every 6 months, yearly, bi-monthly, anytime you how you want to, however you want to, you can select. These are the payment methods that we have. Okay, so you click on okay, and you have it separated with commas and columns. Okay, so once you're done here, you just cancel this and you will be able to see it. So let's click out to see the preview. So once you see it, come to payment schedule, so you can just click on the drop down and you can see monthly, 6 months, yearly, and bi-monthly. So assuming you choose a particular part, and it just appear as our choice. So this is very, very interesting and important to. So let's get back to the design mode. Next is we have the pathways that are available. Okay, we have a range of pathways that you can choose from. So for example, let's say we have up to you can select more than one if you want. So let's use the checkbox, because that is the feature that enables you to choose more than one. So for example, we type in the first here, first checkbox, and you double click, and then you put in presentation mastery. Okay, so these are first choice. We can click again to put in the second choice, double click, and then you can put in maybe leadership development and click out, and then we can have the last option, which is effective coaching. Okay, we say okay, and you have your forms created. So if you want, you can space them out a little bit more, okay, so that they can appear uniform. And if you want to bring in, you can bring them down a little, so that you can delete this space so that the forms can be fully fixed, and you can reduce the length of this so that it can be fully sized within the box. Okay, the last thing we want to put is terms and conditions. So you have the option to put in as you wish. Now we can put in this one to just put in the terms and condition. I want to put something like I accept the terms and condition, and we can just double click and put in over here, accept the terms and conditions. Okay, so you close out, and once the person wants to accept, he just tick this box and he accepts. Okay, so you have a range of other options down here. You can choose, put in images, you can put in the push button, you can put in formatted fields, you can put in numerical fields if you want someone to put in numerical or numbers, something like from on this place where we ask the person to put the phone number. You can put the numerical field if you want, and the text also can still work the same way. You can put in time field, anytime, anywhere, depending on you. Image control, you can put in image, you can bring in image, you can ask the person to attach his photo or something, or to upload an image or thereabout. You have table controls and the pattern controls and all that. You can try, you're free to try all these features and see how and what you can use them for actually. So this is just our form. We can try to look at the preview and see how it looks. So this is how it looks. I think it kind of look fantastic to me. This is the form. You fill in your name, your details, your date of birth, and you put in your experience, your reason why you join, and all this. Once you're done, the next thing is to output this. So there are two ways to output. You can directly export directly as a PDF. Okay, once you click on this, you can export this directly as a PDF. Device the location where you want to put it, maybe in the document, and then you can put registration, and then you save. Once you save, you can navigate to that particular location and see your form, how it looks. All right, so you can double click to open it, and then you have your form over here. You're free to fill up the form, fill up everything, fill in and put in the years of experience, put in the reason why you join and all that. So this is the first method. The second method is you can easily come to the file over here and say export as, so you can export as PDF also. Right now we just exported directly as PDF. You can export as PDF, and you can see a bunch of options here. You can just go ahead and specify the format as PDF. Okay, submit format PDF. You can see other bunch of formats that you have, but I usually recommend you go for PDF, and so much more. So no need to choose any click anything. You can just export over here, and you can specify the same direction that you want, and then save it. So you have your form to play around with. All right, so you have your form fully prepared, you can just fill in, or you can send to someone to fill and send back to you very easily through your email, through any kind of the social media handles. So if you enjoyed this video, feel free to give it a thumbs up, and remember to hit the like and subscribe button to keep enjoying related useful videos from this channel. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.